Hello everyone, this is Rajiv Kohli and welcome back to our channel The Teacher. And today I am going to show you that how you can create this zoom in animated scene in PowerPoint 2016. So let's get started. So as you can see that I have drawn all these shape using the shape tools. And let me show you a few things before we dig into animations. So I open the selection pane from the home tab. And here you can see all the objects that I have included in this presentation. As you can see that butterfly 2, which is this one, is on top of the list. That means it is on front of all the other objects. Then we have the scene layer 1, which is this one. And then scene layer 2, which is this one. And then butterfly 1, which is before scene layer 3. And I will explain you that why I have put this butterfly 1 before scene layer 3. And then finally we have clouds. And if I expand this scene layer 1, then you can see all the objects that I have drawn to create this first layer. And let me show you by ungrouping all of them. After selecting the object, go to the format tab, click the group drop down button and then ungroup. And here you can see that all the objects that I have drawn. And for tree, I have used rounded corner rectangles, as you can see here. And then group them together to create a single tree here. And for the mountains, I have used the freeform shape tool. Let me show you an example here. When you need to use a freeform tool, click it once, then move your mouse pointer, then click again and do that until you draw a complete shape here. And later you can go to the format tab, click the edit shapes drop down button and then click edit points. And to make a curve here, right click on the point and choose smooth point. That way you can easily draw shapes using the freeform shape tool. Okay, let me delete this one. So using the same method, I have drawn all these layers here, as you can see. So let me close this presentation without saving it and then open it back again. So once you have completed drawing all the shapes here to make an entire scene, then we will move to the animations. So let me close this one and open the animation pane. From the animations tab, click animation pane, and here you can see all the animations that I have used in this presentation. So I will delete all these animations and will start from the beginning. To delete all the animations, select the first one, hold down the shift key, then select the last one and hit the delete key from the keyboard. So for the scene 1, which is this one, this layer, you can also open the selection pane along with the animation pane, so you can notice that which object you have selected. So as you can see that I have selected scene layer 1. So after selecting the scene layer 1, go to the animations tab, click the add animation drop down button and then choose grow shrink. Okay, now as you know that I always use start with previous for all of my animations. So I will use with previous, and here I would like to apply a duration of 6 seconds. So the duration is up to you that how much time you want to give PowerPoint to zoom in to this scene layer 1. Now double click the animation to open the effect options window. And here you can see that the default size is 150%, but I want 200%, so I will click this drop down button and will change the amount to 200%. And I want to grow and shrink in both sides horizontally and vertically, so it is checked by default. Then go to the timing tab, and here I need to apply a 6 second duration and hit the OK button. That's fine. Now what you can do, you can select the scene layer 1 and then click the animation painter and then click on scene layer 2. that will apply the same animation to the scene layer 2 as well. And what I only need to change here is the percent of the grow and shrink effect. And for scene layer 2, I will apply 135% with the same settings, like 6 seconds duration, no repeat, no smoothness, and no auto reverse. Hit the OK button. That's fine. Now we have the scene layer 3, and we need to apply the same grow shrink animation to the scene layer 3 as well. So I will select either scene layer 2 or scene layer 1 and then click the animation painter and then click on the scene layer 3. What I only need to do is to change the percentage that I want to apply on the scene layer 3. And for scene layer 3, I will apply 115%. Hit the OK button and let me show you the slideshow. I have given different percentages, so it will create a more realistic effect for all the layers. Now for butterfly 1, I want to apply a custom motion path, and you will not find custom motion path in more motion path animation list. As you can see that there's no custom motion path. So first you need to select the object on which you want to apply the custom motion path. Then from animations tab, pull down the animation drop down list and then click the custom path and draw the path that you want to apply to the butterfly. And finally double click to close the path. So start type will always be with previous, and for butterfly, either you can give the 6 second duration which will match with the scene layers as well, or you can increase the duration if you want to, as I am going to apply 10 second duration for butterfly. Now open the effect option window, and if you want to apply the smoothness, start smoothness and end smoothness, it is up to you, or you can also disable the smoothness if you want to, but I would like to go with a start smoothness with 0.35 and end smoothness with 0.95 and a duration of 10 seconds. Hit the OK button. As you can see, our butterfly is moving, and that is why I have put this butterfly after scene layer 1 and scene layer 2, because I want to hide that butterfly behind the scene layer 2, between the scene layer 3 and scene layer 2, because I want when the butterfly moves down, then it should hide behind the scene layer 2. Now the next animation that I will apply on this butterfly is grow shrink. So apply the grow shrink effect and open the effect option window, and here I will apply a 30% grow shrink, but only horizontal. And I also want to apply auto reverse. I want this butterfly to grow 30% horizontally and then reverse back to its original size without smoothness, with the auto reverse, and repeat until end of the slide. Want to start it with previous, and the duration is very important here. As you know that butterfly move very fast, so I will apply only 0.01 second duration for the grow shrink effect. So the butterfly will grow and shrink very fast, and it will create a flying butterfly effect. Let me show you the slideshow. Okay, so the next animation is, I also want this butterfly to spin a little bit, so it will create a more realistic effect here, and for that I will apply the spin animation, start with previous with a duration of 2 seconds and open the effect option window, and I don't want any smoothness here, but I want to reverse the spin animation to back to its original position, and would like to spin this butterfly to 90 degree counterclockwise, and would like to repeat this animation until end of the slide. So let's see the slideshow. So you can customize the motion path as you want, as I want to move this end point here, So what you can do, you can fetch the effect option drop down window and click edit points, and here you can easily move the points where you want to. That's fine. Now it's time for the clouds, and it is very simple. Select the clouds, go to add animations, click more motion path and apply left motion path to the clouds. Hit the OK button and change the motion path size if you want to. Start it with previous, with a duration of 6 seconds or 8 seconds or 10 seconds. It is up to you. That if you want to match the timing with the scene layers, then you can apply 6 seconds. If you want the cloud to move slower, then you can increase the timing. So open the effect option window, and I don't want any smoothness for the clouds and don't want to repeat it anyway. Hit the OK button, and finally we have butterfly 2, and for that I will apply a motion path of diagonal upright, and you can move it anywhere. I want to move it to left, so I will drag and drop it right here. Open the effect option window, and I don't want any smoothness for this one, and start with previous, and see, the butterfly 2 has the same animation as butterfly 1, but only difference is the motion path. So what you can do, you can delete this one, select the butterfly 1 and then click, select the butterfly 1 and then click the animation painter and then click on the butterfly 2. So the only thing you need to change is the motion path. So you can either customize the motion path by again going to the effect option window and then click edit points, and here I can delete the points that I no longer required by right clicking on any point and then choose delete point. You have to click very carefully exactly on the point, so you will see all the options. And then move the path. That way you have, that way you don't have to apply all the animation from the beginning. So let's see the slideshow. So that's working fine, and I hope you will find this video informative and interesting and will learn something new. Let me know by leaving your valuable comments in the section below, and don't forget to hit the like button and share this video with your friends. You can subscribe to our channel for more upcoming tutorial videos. Thanks for watching and have a great day.